Zodiac brings you 5 symbolisms of the reptilian Vatican Hall. Number 5. First, some context. Yesterday I found a giant serpentine monument in the Pope's audience hall, namely in Pope the Fourth's audience hall, or so it's named. The audience hall itself is made of reinforced concrete by an architect that was known for building bunker-like public structures, indeed monuments, out of concrete. It was built in 1977, so it's really old in fact. It's been around there for a long time. But my first lead that something was strange was this window, and I said, that looks like an eye. It looks like a serpent's eye. So I dug a little deeper, and when I saw the audience hall from the back, where the back audience was seated, it really did take my breath away, since what was revealed was this right here. That is a giant, massive reptilian face shaped into the direct architecture. Everything from the slits in the eyes to the scales to the fangs, there was no mistake about it. But what's behind this hinted symbolism? And what can we see or glean if we dig deeper? Well, number 4, look at where the Pope is seated. We see him here from the back of the hall, that is in fact seated in the mouth of the serpent or reptilian, in the very mouth. This is symbolic of the Pope being the voice of the serpent, in fact speaking the serpent's words to the audience. This might well shake your faith, that is if you're a Catholic, which I was. I actually went to Catholic school myself and was an altar boy. But here you can see it in plain view. Clear symbolism, clear evidence that something here is extremely wrong. This image hasn't been photoshopped. This is real. This is built right into the architecture that was designed by those within the Pope's inner sanctum. But there is more symbolism. For this though, we have to go outside. Number 3. Do you see anything strange here? You're looking at the hall itself. Do you see anything weird? Well, if you look carefully, it looks like the head of a giant snake. Can you see it now? In fact, it's almost unmistakable. You can see the snake's muzzle at the front and you can see its eye. It just looks like a snake. To me, this is yet more connective symbolism that what's going on inside matches the outside. Because since here we can see serpentine architecture with ease. Number 2. Let's head back inside and look at what the Pope himself sees. If the Pope is seated where he is, what does he see? Well, he sees a giant serpent with eyes once again. The audience is symbolic of almost the serpent's meal, and the Pope is not preaching to the audience under this symbolism, but the giant godlike reptilian creature himself. Why? Because this is what the Pope sees. Can you imagine that when they were designing this, that they designed this all by mistake? That this is some kind of high anomaly? No, because they spent literally years on the designs. They definitely would have known what the Pope would have seen from where he was actually speaking. Also, what the audience was seeing. So this is very strange and it raises some serious questions. What is going on in the hall? Number 1. But the biggest clue, the biggest symbolism that tells us something is really, really wrong here is in fact what is missing from the hall, not what is inside it. Do you know what that is? Here is a clue. Now, think of the heart of Christianity and think of what symbol it has and think of what you do not see in this hall. You do not see any of it. That's right. There is no Christian cross. There is no cross in the entire building, at least no large statue, wall hanging, or anything. There's no other real Christian symbolism either. There's no Virgin Mary, there's no Joseph the carpenter. There is indeed nothing anywhere. All of these symbols are missing. But you might say, what about that 10-ton bronze statue that's seated behind the Pope, where, as the Vatican states, Christ has been resurrected from a nuclear apocalypse or a nuclear bomb? To which I would say, this, I believe, is a direct corruption of symbolism. That is, they've taken the former Catholic symbolism of Jesus Christ, and they've displayed it in a corrupted manner, therefore corrupting its meaning. This is just not the way that you display Jesus Christ in any kind of Christianic religious order. You don't display Jesus Christ with massive wings on his back, rising up from an atomic apocalypse. You just don't do this. Look at representations of Christ from the past, just to compare. Take a look. Now you can see that there's just a huge, vast difference here. Something is profoundly wrong. I mean, this statue, which weighs 10 tons, just looks like some massive thing, like a boss from some video game or something from some horror movie. You just don't display Christ like this. And also note in this, Christ appears to have massive wings on his back. Half of his face also looks like it's missing, like he's been heavily damaged by the blast. Is this really how you display Jesus Christ? Ask yourself that. You don't even have to be religious. Just look at history and compare. So what is happening? Well, I don't know, but I'm gonna continue to dig, you can be sure of that. But I think that this is significant and something really big has been revealed here. Something we've found at the end of this trail of breadcrumbs, which started at a small pizza shop a month ago and led us all the way to the Vatican. Anyway, go out there and decide for yourselves. I don't want to tell anyone what to believe. At the end of the day, you have to judge for yourself. It's really the only way to always stay objective and find the answers. In the meantime, please give the video a like if you did like it. That would help me out a great deal. And let me know and others what you think in the comments section. Share any leads you have. I think right now at a time like this, it's important to stay informed and crowdsource our ideas. In the meantime, this is Ed from the Outer Dark. And
Nine rings were gifted to the race of men who above all else desire power. For within these rings was bound the strength and will to govern each race.
I'm not gonna hurt you, Nikki. Remember me. Remember who I am.
That's a Freemason symbol.
Was Coronado in the Masons?
One ring to rule them all.
Maybe one of these red Indians wandered into Whitechapel and indulged his natural inclinations.
Hey. You move, I'll put a bullet through your fucking head.
Peter Fair doesn't agree with me, but the price sure is right.
This is so perfect. Amanda Beckett is single. And on the night of this party, a party I'll be attending, a party she'll be attending, it's all falling into place. It's like it's fate.
It's mine.
My own.
My precious.
Precious?
What if something were to happen to you? Something unforeseeable, something sudden, random.
Make a deal with me, kid. You can have the car and everything that goes along with it.
Looks like we got ourselves a contract.
We shake hands.
Leave. You can't trust the man you've hired to kill your wife. Then oh, I know you.
Стэн откажет мне, ты ему за это платишь, поэтому я прошу тебя, Уэйд. Это очень поможет мне, Джин и Скотти.
Джин и Скотти никогда не придется ни о чем.
Adaptable to steaming jungles and burning deserts and frozen arctic wastes. Well, of course, it's adaptable because it's a robot.
Talk it over. I have to take this call. Cynthia, you change the fucking font on the promo, why?
We'll do it. We'll do it.
Ken Garver here. Look, can't this wait? I'm in the middle.
No. Gone. I'm on my way.
Okay, listen, Tug. When this phone rings, you answer it. You understand?
Yes, I answer it.
You and you alone. Are we clear?
Me and me alone. Right.
Great.
Excellent. That's a Freemason symbol.
Smooth to the touch.
Easy, Tiger.
This ruby, fallen from the very brow of ancient kings, a true crown jewel.
Isildur's pain.
What a man!
Surely my
You have to go with what he says. He's never let us down yet.
I see. Another mystery.
Have one of your people check her out.
You know I can't do that. One whisper of this wouldn't just destroy Deputy Prime Minister Strong. It would bring down the whole government.
Where you want it?
Bay 12, please.
I love DJing. I love music. What's your dream playlist?
What is the profession?
Yeah, which profession are we talking about?
Just look at it. Is it a legal profession?
Of course it's legal.
It's only in my profession.
I'm trying to read it.
Okay.
It's too many diamonds. Ah!
Yeah, that's too bright.
That's too bright. Well, anyway.
Oh, Macy, are you a Mason?
Of course I am.
Okay.
You might as well put your pinky out when you drink
of
your drink.
Course I am.
Wow. Put your pinky out.
You're involved in the secret ceremony?
Stop it.
Destroy it!
No.
You see, dude?
You with me, Jimmy?
And the book says we may be through with the past, but the past ain't through with us. I shall tell you where we are.
I wish the ring had never come to me. I wish none of this had happened.
ring of my profession. You don't know nothing about that.
Okay, well, can we get a close-up on that? There it is.
What? You don't know nothing about
what
that.
What is the profession?
Yeah, which profession are we talking about?
Just look at it.
Is it a legal profession?
Of course it's legal. It's a ring of my profession.
Well, anyway.
Oh, Mason,
are you a Mason?
Of course I am.
Okay.
You
have a secret ceremony.
Well, you might as well put your pinky out when you drink
of
your drink.
Of course I am.
Wow. Put your pinky out.
Are you involved in the secret ceremonies with the pencils and the...
Everyone wears...
Anyway, the Clippers. The Clippers.
But that is impressive, Mr. O'Neill.
Look into my eye.